Peace to the Macadine family and listening audience. I am Kamil Shabazz of Macadine University. Hoping all is well with you. This is actually my 30th day of the, what I would refer to as the 6-8 marathon. We're actually for the whole 30 days at the basis of what I've been talking about is man's binary relationship with the 6 and the 8. Coming out of that 6 material existence and eventually through self-effort, you eventually rise into your 8, which is your infinite self, your almighty self. So, I'm out of breath. I've been moving, running back and forth. But I covered everything. I covered examples of that 6 and 8 through entertainment, using James Brown as an example of someone resonating on the infinite mind and looking at themselves as being the greatest, the highest, the Godfather. Then I went into religion, giving you an example via Father Divine, who called himself Almighty God. We're dealing with a mindset, that infinite mindset. So, the title of this one, I'm dealing with the 6 and 8 relationship with Mike Tyson, Muhammad Ali, George Foreman. And by the way, today is Iron Mike Tyson's, I think, 56th birthday. 56th birthday, 28 times 2. I've been dealing with that 28 this week also because I mentioned Mike Tyson 2 days ago on 6/28 when I told you that in that historic review of people throughout all the world for up to 1,000+ years, Mike Tyson, Malcolm X, and Mark Clark were the only ones mentioned, and I went into that a couple of days ago. So I'm going to go deeper into Mike and his relationship with the number 6. As I said, he's 56 today. He was born on this date, 1966. Those sixes. His name, born Michael Gerard Tyson, 7, 6, and 5 letters, that's 18. 3 sixes. Check it out. In today's date, 6 times 30 is 180. That's another 18. So Mike was born with all these sixes around him, but it doesn't mean bad unless you're brought up the way a brother like Mike was brought up, on the negative side of the 6 that he was born on. Because as I said, all numbers are good until they are used in the wrong way. So keep that in mind. But the foundation of what I'm talking about rests on the great and legendary first black heavyweight champion of the world, Jack Johnson. When I was talking about that mindset that James Brown had, that Father Divine had, that's the mindset that Jack Johnson had, who was born in 1887 on all 8s. He was already born in that 8 energy, that God energy. So when he won the crown, he won the crown in 1908 on that 8. But he lost the crown 1915 on that 6. Then he retired 1928. As I was telling you about the scapegoating thing that takes place to the black man and on the black man in America on that number 28. He was always the scapegoat because he went against the grain, had white wives when you could get lynched for whistling at a white woman. He had white women as girlfriends and wives, so they hated him. And they were always on the heels of Jack Johnson trying to arrest him. He was a fugitive. He had to fight in other countries. But he still maintained that God posture that we talk about, that mindset of being your greater self, being great as everybody else at the very least. And people don't realize that Jack Johnson invented the monkey wrench. And the reason why they call it the monkey wrench was as a disrespect to that God's creativity. And every damn mechanic shop in the world has Jack Johnson's invention in it. So what I'm going to talk about regarding Muhammad Ali, Mike Tyson, and George Foreman is based on that God mind. Because I talk about Ali in our chapter called Praise because of Ali's mindset. The greatest. He was the greatest. He had that mindset that no other boxer ever had. Until Mike Tyson, of course. But we know because Mike Tyson came under the wing of the great Custer Model. Which that's another subject. So now let's go into Muhammad Ali and George Foreman. Muhammad Ali was born on the 17th of January, 1942. That 17 is 8, and that 42 is 6. George Foreman, because I'm talking about their fight. Their fight was the greatest fight in the history of boxing. The fight between Muhammad Ali and George Foreman. And 6 and 8 is intertwined and saturated in this whole cosmic drama. Because that's all it is. As it is above, so it is beneath. And when any great sports event of a great universal magnitude takes place, it's related to above. But only the wise can comprehend. So let's get to Muhammad. He wins the Olympic medal, gold medal, in 1960. That's a 6. George Foreman, who was born on the 10th of January, 1949, all those numbers equal 6. Yet, he won the 1968 gold medal for the Olympics. Come on now. We're talking about this 6 and 8 in the greatest fight in the history of all fights. Because it relates and ties in to what I've been talking about yesterday, David and Goliath. David and Goliath. Because the fight between Muhammad Ali and George Foreman was not just cosmic, but it was of biblical proportions. Let's go into it. Now, the fight took place between George Foreman and Muhammad Ali, October 30th, 1974. Keep in mind that October means 8. Although it's the 10th month of the year, it means 8. And that the fight between the two was actually supposed to take place several weeks earlier, but George Foreman got cut. Got cut in the eye, so it had to be delayed for a month or so. So it was all part of this alignment that had to take place because it took place October 3rd, 1974. And you got that 3 and 8, which we was talking about, deals with that father mindset that we talk about. That God mindset that Ali went in there with at the age of 32. That's that 5 I was talking about from the first book of Samuel. Huh? 17. That 8. That 58. Ali was on that 58. He was on that 58. See? George Foreman was 25 years old. 25 years old. Now, if you look at this, check this out. This is going to show that George Foreman represents the lower self in this drama. He's stuck on 6. Like I said, 1-10-49. That adds up to 15, which is 6. He won the 1968 Olympics. But, check it out. When he goes to fight Ali, he goes with a German Shepherd with him. The Beast. The Beast. Ali is out there on a totally different plane. Ali, Bumbaye, Ali, Bumbaye. The whole energy of the whole nation is behind Ali. And then you got the word Kinshasa, where they fought at. Kinshasa Zaire. Kinshasa is 8 letters. Come on, listen to what I'm saying. Zaire is 5 letters. You got that 5 and 8. Ali was in the zone. Then they was in a ring that was 240 feet in length. That's a 6. 60,000 people. And the name George has 6 letters. And the name Muhammad has 8 letters. Can't make this shit up. This right here was a cosmic drama. But like I said, only the wise could comprehend. And what gave Ali the edge was his corner. See, he was surrounded by the 3 wise men. Drew Boudini Brown. Angelo Dundee. And the word Angelo Dundee means angel of fire. Then you got Don King. And as much as we hate Don King, Don King was the king. He created that out of thin air, out of his imagination, and had them signing contracts without having no money. But he had a vision. And promised both of them $5 million and didn't have nothing but an idea and a will behind it. And knowing that he was going to make it happen, because Don King was also in that mindset. That's what has him till this day being the king of promoters. Hate him or not. So, Ali has 8 letters in his name. George has 6 in his name. And why the hell did Ali knock Foreman out in the 8th round? Huh? Come on now. Come on. Can't make this shit up. Can't make it up. But I'm going to go a little bit deeper. Because I've been talking about that 6 and 8 relationship in regards to the pyramids, which is actually nothing but a macrocosm of us, our brain, our system as a man and woman. Having that king's chamber in the brain that's calcified, called the pineal gland that I've been teaching you about. It goes deeper. This cosmic drama with Ali informing goes way deeper. So put on your scuba gear. Now, in the Great Pyramid of Giza, who this pyramid was built by Thoth and not Cheops or Taffer or whatever his name, Khufu. Puff. So anyway, it's nothing but a macrocosm of us once again. Now, the name Ali means the Most High. And the Most High is within here. All right? King's Chamber of the Pyramids. Now, did you know that in our skull, we have a part, a ventricle, called the foramen that goes to the pineal gland? You can't make this shit up. So you got the Most High that's already in you, and you got Foreman who is helping you to get to the Most High. Which George Foreman, when Ali beat that Goliath, he was officially on the throne and in the zone. And he wasn't supposed to fight no more. No more. He had slayed Goliath, and he was the greatest. He didn't have to prove anything to nobody but his advisors, the great Don, Drew Boudini Brown. Drew Boudini Brown was born 1928. I've been talking about that 28. But they were all stuck on 6. Boudini Brown, even though he was the one who came up with the phrase, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee, he was a dope fiend. He was stuck on 6. That's why he sold Muhammad Ali's belt for $500. He pawned it. These were devils around Ali. And when Ali went out to fight Foreman, he stopped at the gate while they was about to walk out. And he turned around and looked at all his camp. He said, "God damn, I'm the one fighting. Why y'all look like y'all going to a funeral?" Because all of them thought that he was going to lose to Goliath. Don King, like he said in that movie, he said, "I know you betting on him. I know you got him picked. But like he said, I'm going to shock the world." And he shocked the world, not because he was a Muslim. Because men like Ali, Malcolm, Garvey, it wouldn't matter if they were politicians, dog catchers, or whatever. Who you are is who you are, and you're going to shine as that individual wherever you go. So Islam didn't make Ali. That germ was already in him, and it was going to germinate somewhere else. Come on. So, peace to those that's in the audience. You said first black woman Supreme Court Justice, 26. That's another 8. That's what I'm talking about. 8 is that infinite tone that we need to be on. And it was in October that they fought, like I said. In October, which means 8. So, Ali was at the pinnacle of success. And he didn't have to fight no more. He shouldn't have fought anymore. Shouldn't have did it. And that was his downfall, because he had greedy, filthy, snarling, vicious devils around him who would kick him out of his religion. And then when things went good, they'd call him back in. But when he was struggling out there with no money, he couldn't call on them. But once he got his crown and the coffers got full, "Oh, you can come on in now." "Yes, sir, Muhammad Ali." Yeah. Shit is funny. So, got my head. I gotta put some water on my head. So it's that God energy, brothers. That's where I'm getting at. And it's everywhere. It's in the sports arena. It's in politics. Once you're lined up, you will see the cosmic dance of 6 and 8 everywhere. And you can utilize that power. All it represents is you having your right over your left and standing on your square and telling the truth regardless to whom or what, and allowing nature to take its course on your enemies, because you don't have to raise one hand in this day and time. You don't even have to raise your voice, because if you're in the Aquarian energy, you have the backing of the angels, as they would say. So I didn't want to be long, but I just wanted to give you that aspect, you know, of from a sports point of view, to let you see that this number 6 and 8 is everywhere, because it's the foundation through which we got to go to where we're trying to go by nature, and that is to our infinite self. To come out of the negative and into the eternal positive. Because the objective of the Maccabean, hold on 1 second, might be too late, shit. The objective of the Maccabean is once again to bring you into that God mindset, to regenerate you mentally, for you to have that self-respect and love that's necessary, because love, which is the 8th chapter of our book, is actually the fuel that you need to stay on that journey, much less get on that journey. Because once again, love spelled backwards is evol, which symbolizes and signifies evolving to your higher self. Is there anything else I need to say before I depart? Think that may be it. Think that may be it. And if I forget anything, I will definitely bring it up tomorrow. Have a wonderful evening. Salute and peace.